Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on how to use the new online archiving feature within Outlook. The aim of this video is to provide user guidance on how to import PSD files to the archive, archive emails, and set retention policies. The Outlook Online Archive is a new, built-in archive feature, much like an extra inbox. It initially offers 100 GB of extra storage, however, it is self-expanding if you require more storage. It also allows for you to access your archived emails without the need to connect to a VPN or network and means that you can also access them using the Outlook web app. There are two ways to receive the N365 package, via either your desktop or the web, and both methods provide the online archive feature. There are some minor changes to wording and some settings, and given this, we will cover both means of access. Starting with the desktop version, if you look to your left-hand vertical taskbar, seated below your personal folders, you will see your access to your personal online archive. You will note that there are two archive folders. One of these sits within your standard Outlook folders, and the other that is identified by having your email address alongside it. The online archive is the one that is separate to your main mailbox. If we now look at the online archive on the web app, the basic principles of the archive are very similar. One thing to note is that it is called the in-place archive followed by your email address as opposed to the online archive. When you click on the main online archive tab, you will be presented with three headings: deleted items, archive, and search folders. By right-clicking on the archive heading, you will be able to create subfolders, rename a folder, delete folders, etc. as per normal practice with email folders. Please note, the deleted items folder is only for deleted items from your online archive and not from your main mailbox. As you will be aware, we have an agreement with Microsoft and NHS Digital to remove Office 2010 from all devices in the trust by the 1st of May 2022 and replace it with N365. As part of this move, all PSD files will be made read-only on the 4th of April 2022. Meaning you will be unable to add any more emails to them and they will need to be moved into the Outlook Online Archive to continue using them. A PSD file is an email archive that is saved locally, i.e., on the G or H drives, and will only be available via the desktop version of Outlook if you are connected to a trust network or VPN. The easiest method is to drag and drop either a single email or a complete folder into the online archive folder or subfolder of your choosing. If you need to import a larger PSD file into the archive, you can do so by selecting the File tab and then going on to the Open and Export section. From here, you will need to select the Import/Export option. The options may be different on older versions of Outlook. On Outlook 2010, the option may only be called Import. Once you have located this, select Import from another program or file and then click Next. Then select Outlook Data File, click Next, and you will be able to choose the PSD you would like to import from your G or H drive. You will then be given the option of what folder you would like to import the PSD into, and you can select your online archive. If you are struggling to locate your PSD file, select the File tab and then under the Account Settings option, select Account Setting from the drop-down. On the Account Settings window, there is a Data Files tab. In this, you will see all the locations of your open PSD files. If you select Open File Location, you can then copy the file location and paste this into the File Explorer when you are wanting to import your PSD files. If you are still unable to locate your PSD files, please contact the service desk. Once you have finished this, you should see the item or items in your online archive folder. Please note that the larger the PSD file or folder you are importing, the longer this will take. We would recommend using the OWA or another computer while this move takes place so that you can continue to use Outlook. Unlike the desktop version, the option to import PSD files into your archive is not available via the OWA. We would therefore encourage you to move your PSD files into your online archive as this is more easily accessible and readily available. To move items to your online archive, you can either drag and drop them into the archive or set a policy to move them over automatically after they have been in your inbox for a set period. You can set this policy for both an individual email and your folders. To set it for an individual email, right-click on the email and select Assign Policy. Here you will be given the choice of selecting one of three options. You will also note that there is a retention policy option below this. The retention policy allows Outlook to automatically delete emails after your selected period. To set the archiving policy for a folder, right-click on the folder of your choice and select Properties. Click on the Policy tab, where you can then select your desired archiving period. As with the desktop version, there are several methods by which you can move items into the in-place archive on the Outlook web app. These can be done manually or automatically. The manual process to drag and drop individual emails remains the same as the desktop version. However, if you would like to move a whole folder into your archive, you will have to select all the emails within this folder and then drag and drop those into the online archive folder. From here, within the archive folder, you can create a new subfolder for these items. To assign an automatic archiving policy to an individual email, select the email and then click on the three little dots on the horizontal ribbon. Click on the Assign Policy tab and from here, you will be able to select your preferred option. Also available from here is access to the retention policy. To assign a policy to a folder, right-click on the folder of your choice and select the Assign Policy tab. We are aware this will be a big change for many who have become accustomed to using the traditional PST format, but the new online archive will allow you to access your files anytime, any place, anywhere and on any device. In addition to this, the archive has a considerable storage capacity. The online archive is just one of the many useful new features that comes with M365, and to help you with this new package, we have linked the Microsoft guidance on all the apps below. If you need any help or guidance with using the archive, please contact the service desk. Thank you for watching.